So hello and greetings to the all the viewers. Today we will going to see ellipsoid head with eccentric nozzle and reinforcing pad modeling using ANSYS workbench. So there are like different modeling softwares available in the market like Unigraphics, CATIA, ProE, SolidWorks, SolidEdge. But here we will try to model ellipsoid head with eccentric nozzle which may also contains reinforcing pad over that using ANSYS workbench. So here the challenge will be like we had already seen one of my video there. I had shown vertical vessel modeling, but there few challenge will come when there is a eccentric nozzle will be there which may contest reinforcing pad. So how to model that? So in this video we will try to learn that in a simpler way. Okay, then we will start now. This slide represent the learnings in this video. First we will see the problem definition of this RF pad modeling, then we'll move towards our actual ANSYS simulation part. Therefore first we will try to model pressure vessel head, that is like 2S2 1 ellipsoid head. Then we will see the eccentric nozzle modeling, and then we will see the reinforcing pad modeling for that. Okay, so this slide represent the problem definition, like head with eccentric nozzle and reinforcing pad modeling. If you see here, this is what your 2S1 ellipsoid head, and this is your eccentric nozzle which is having a 30 inch eccentric above the center axis, which may contains like RF pad 5 inch wide as well as 0.75 inch thickness. And this nozzle is nothing but your 20 inch your outer diameter and thickness of 0.75 inches. So, and you can see this is like 50 inch IOD and 1 inch thickness. So we'll model this vessel and we'll see. Okay, then we'll move towards our actual ANSYS part. So from this 2D drawing we can model this part. So here like the challenge will come like how to model this RF pad, because here it is eccentric and this shape is your ellipsoid shape. So that is the thing, like I will tell you the simpler way how to model that. So we will quickly move towards our actual ANSYS window. So what I will do, I will open ANSYS. We will move towards our actual ANSYS part. Just cross check the units and keep metric or US customary as per your convenience. Now right click on this geometry and then click on new design modeler. So right, your design modeler is open. Then first cross check the units. Our dimensions are in inches, so I will be keeping all the dimensions will be in inch. So out of these three planes you can select any one plane as a reference and just click on a sketch. So I'm clicking, so you can see the sketch will be on XY plane, and go to the sketching mode. So and make view as per your front view. Then you can see if you drag and drop bottom side you will find ellipse. Just click on this, click on a horizontal axis and click on a vertical axis, right? So here once your axis will be defined like vertical and horizontal, then later on you can define a dimensions for dimension menu. Select general, by default it will be general. Click on horizontal axis and click on vertical axis. So this is your major axis and this is your minor axis. In our case major axis will be like 50 inches while minor axis will be 25 inch, because it is 2S2 1. So suppose right click here and zoom to fit. Suppose this is your ID will be 100 inches, then your vertical height will be 100 divided by 4, so it will be like 25. 2S2 1, it will be like this. Suppose this is 2 and this is 1, so it will be like that. So right now it is 50, then it will be 25. So like that you need to model ellipsoid ellipse. Then once it is done, go to modify. What we will do, we will select only quarter portion and remaining portion we will
use for a revolve. Okay, now our sketch is done. There are two ways. You can create another offset sketch by defining thickness, or you can go directly to model, generate, and go to directly revolve. Select that sketch and click on a geometry. I will expand this. Here select this vertical axis, apply, add frozen. There is small difference between add material and add frozen. Add material, what you will do, suppose if you do add material and later on if you do another geometry creation on the same, then what will do, it will merge in the existing geometry. If you do add frozen, it will create a separate entity later on also. Okay, now you define an angle and define like dimension. If you want, there are normal, reverse, symmetric, or sometimes it will be asymmetric. In our case, it is like, no, I will keep normal. And here one option is given, like as a thin surface. So you do here as a thin surface and define your thickness. Okay, now simply generate over here. So if you see our and here you can define, in our case it will be like our OD. So see, if your ID will be like this, this is what your ID. You can define thickness in outer direction. If you are ellipse, what we have drawn, it is having a dimension of OD, then you can draw thickness in inside one. We will go for our model, and so in our case you can see 50 inch ID and 1 inch is the thickness. So here like it will be ID. So what I will do, I will keep 1 inch over here and 0. So I will give the dimension inside. See, okay, it will be like a IOD. I think our previous is proper one. So 50 inch. See, this is what our ID line and 1 inch thickness. So like that you can create a ellipse. Once your ellipse is done, you can go for another dimension, that is 10 inch offset you can do, and then later on we will model a plane at 30 inch offset from center line. So here go for uncheck frozen body transparency, select it and extrude. You can define here direction, so like that I am selecting, I will keep opposite direction, and here like 10 inch. So generate. In our, in your, suppose this option, suppose if it is not active, then you can go to tool option, and then from there you can activate this beta function, then only you are able to see this function. Okay, now there are, like you can see, two different geometries are created. Now we will move towards another geometry. I will hide this. What I will do, I will create one more plane. See, plane will be created by the at global coordinate system, and now I will translate that plane 30 degree offset here, offset along x axis 30 inch, and also I will further offset along y axis 40 inch. Okay, so here one plane is created. Generate. Now we will create, see, though you have created a plane, but it is not in, you should always keep in mind your sketch will be drawn in XY plane. So here we need to rotate in such a way that it will be XY. Your horizontal plane will be XY. So what I will do, I will further edit selection. I will go over here and I will rotate along X axis, and I will keep 90 degrees so that it will be like this. Now once it is done, just create a 20 inch and 0.75 inch circle. So go to this plane, further select sketch, go to sketching mode, fit, and then draw one scale, draw one circle over here and give the dimensions, right? So here I will keep 20 inch. Now generate. So go to modeling. Here you can use extrude option. Now go to extrude, select that sketch and apply on a geometry, and here you can do add material or add frozen. I'll keep add frozen. And here, instead of fix, you can do like faces or surface, you can define this and generate. So if you see, it will be solid body, but we want thickened paste. So here, you can right click, edit selection as a thin surface and define a thickness of 1 inch. So this is our OD in this case, and here 0.75 will be the thickness, right? So your offset nozzle is drawn. It is very simple to create offset nozzle, but when you will going to draw reinforcing pad on this face, it is very difficult. So I will tell you the simple way. For that, you just slice this body first. So what I will do, I will slice by this plane, slice all bodies. There are two bodies only. So if you see here, right body, right? So what I will do, I will create on this point one plane. Once your plane is done, just generate on that single point. You can create one plane and then do one thing, go for a sketching further, sketch, and here you can draw whatever the dimensions of that reinforcing pad. In our case, that is like 5 inch is the radius. So I will go to sketching mode and I will give dimensions. So here it will be like 5 inch wide. So it means from this point, this radius will be 5 inch. So like that you need to create. The advantage of drawing sphere is that sphere may have equal distance along its complete periphery. So that's why it will be good if you can draw a sphere. Suppose if you are drawing rectangular, what will happen in some of the portion, so that rectangular will not be proper. So this is what the another way, quite simple way. Once your circle is drawn, just generate, go to modeling menu, and you can use sweep option over here. So I will do this sketch here, go for a sweep and select that your outer axis, right? So and here do add material or add fusion. So if you see here, your circle, sweepable circle is created. This is called sphere. Now what we'll do, by using this sphere, we will split the surface. So go to create boolean option. Here one option is given like imprint faces. So you can select, these are the two targets body which we need to imprint, and you can select this body, right, and simply generate. So what it will do, it will create a splitted surface over here, right? You can see this is what our splitted surface. Now once it is done, you just slice this. I will slice this two bodies, and I will remove inside portion, but here our nozzle will be on this plane, so you can further slice from inside. Okay, select all bodies, generate. Now you can suppress this inside. Now select these two faces and here go create and shell option, thin shell and surface. So here if you see, here 0.75 and here also reinforcing pad 0.75 mm thickness, sorry 0.75 mm will be your, so it will be an outward generate. And here you can keep preserve body, yes, so it will keep that body also. So if you see, your pad is generated, right? So what we did, we had created one sphere, we swept that sphere by using this path, and then we splitted these surfaces, and with that surface we had given a thickness. So this is what the one of the proper way. If you measure dimension all along its periphery, it will be same 5 inch wide only, right? So this is what the simpler approach. Once it is done, you can do one thing, you can further select all and go for this create boolean and just unite this all, select all apply, generate. So once it is done, here I think it unite doesn't work. So what I will do, I will first unite this face, these three bodies, generate. Now if you see, it is a single body. Similarly, I will unite this boolean 1, 2, 3, 4, right, generate. So now what, how to create a weld? So one simple option is that you can go for a chamfer directly. So here one chamfer option is there, and you can define your weld dimensions, weld leg. So I will keep like 2 inch 2 inch kind of thing. So if you see, your weld is created, right? And also if you want, you can gain one inside bend also. So inside bend in the sense fillet. So here go for a bend option, fix radius, go as per your dimension, you can define like 1 inch or 2 inch, whatever the dimension is there. So let's check with our model. So if you see this model and our this model, okay, so what we did, we have from this 2D image we have created this 3D solid. So like that, you need to create at your end. It is very simple, but in where number of nozzles are there, which are more in pressure vessel industry, you will find that eccentric nozzles will be there. But it is very difficult to create a pad and here on this curvature surface. So you can use this simple trick and you can create a complete reinforcing pad. Okay, so thank you guys, thank you for watching this complete video. Let me know your comments. If you have any doubts, I will be there to reply. Okay, thank you once again.